Today on Christian World News, they spent months in an Iranian prison. We'll tell you how these two Christian women survived that ordeal and are now spreading a message of hope.
Plus, this German homeschool family fled persecution in Germany. So why is the United States denying them asylum?
And Truth Unlocked, the new ministry that explains the mysteries of the Islamic faith and how to minister to Muslims.
Inside Iran's worst prison, two Christian women describe their experience in Evin. Hello, everyone. I'm Wendy Griffith.
And I'm George Thomas. CBN News has been following the story of Saeed Abedini, the Iranian-American pastor, currently serving an eight-year sentence in Iran for his Christian faith. He's being held in the notorious Evin prison, where he suffers physical beatings and is denied medical care.
Miriam Rostenpour and her roommate, Marje, spent 7 months inside Evin for their work spreading the gospel. Recently, they shared their experience and rare inside look at what it's like inside that infamous prison. Their story begins with a knock on their door. Take us back to March 2009 when your doorbell rang. What happened?
I looked through the people and I saw Marzia with three guards. My mind was in shock. I just opened the door and they entered our apartment. They ransacked everywhere and they took both of us with all our belongings, like Bibles, books, Jesus movies, and everything that they had discovered in our apartment. And they transferred us to the security police.
For first day and especially the first week was so difficult for both of us because we were so scared. And they threatened us to physical torture. They told us that we will beat you until you vomit blood.
They sent both of us to a very small and dark and dirty cell in the basement. And every minute we were waiting for them to come and to take us for the physical torture. At that day, we were just we hugged each other. We said goodbye. We were thinking that it was our last day on earth.
You both could have been released at any time if you denied your faith. Why didn't you?
We are in love with Jesus, and we couldn't deny our faith. And also, because Jesus in the Bible says that if you wish to follow me, you must pick up your own cross and follow me. And so as a follower of Jesus, it was very important for us to pass through this test with victory. And also, it was an honor for both of us to suffer for our faith.
For 2 weeks, you were in detention, both of you, and then you were moved to the notorious Evin prison. What were the conditions like?
It's awful in Evin prison. For the first 14 days, we didn't have anything to eat. And even in public prison, we could eat just the bread and cheese that they gave to prisoners for breakfast. And that was all we could eat. And I was poisoned once because of the food. And, you know, the medical situation was even worse. There was just a small and dirty clinic, and we couldn't visit the doctor. For 9 months, we were both sick.
How did your faith help you keep your sanity while you were in prison?
Sometimes we couldn't pray in Farsi, our language. We couldn't find words because, you know, that situation is really scary, and our mind was in shock. And in those moments, we were just praying in tongues for each other. For example, when they took Marzia for interrogations, I was praying for her, and she did the same thing for me. And the Holy Spirit really led us in our prayers when we were praying in tongues.
We have many experience with Jesus. We had met him, taught his love, and had seen many miracles. And our personal relationship was very important.
You know, we both believe that Evin is really the heart and brute manifestation of the power of the Ayatollahs and is really the symbol of their dominance and strength over Iran. This prison is notorious for arresting, torturing, raping, and executing of many innocents.
Some of my friends, before I got arrested, they told me, Marzia, you know about Iranian prison and Iranian government, if they rape you in prison, if they torture you, what you will do. And I always, you know, I trust God, and I always told them that I'm sure that God will protect us, but if it happened, I'm sure that God has a reason for this.
At first, you all prayed to be released, But then your prayer changed. What happened?
We had many great opportunity to talk with many prisoners, and there were many prostitutes, addicted people, and they were most of them. They were so hopeless, sad, and disappointed. We had to pray and ask God to show us right person to talk to them. But in that prison, we had more opportunity to talk about Jesus with many women, and also about prostitutes. It was very difficult to find prostitutes in Iran because they are not in a specific place. But when we were in a prison, we find out that there are many prostitutes here, even madams. And we had a great opportunity to talk to them and pray with them. And some of them, they cry and they confess their sins. And it was really like a church for us. And every time, every day, we gather and pray, and it was wonderful.
Wow. No wonder they released you.
Yeah.
We got to get these girls out of here, right?
Yeah. We were more free in prison to talk about Jesus.
Wow, it's incredible.
An incredible conversation with two very brave women, George. And picking up on what she just said there about being more free inside the prison than out, we got news this week that Pastor Saeed is out of solitary confinement. His family was allowed to meet with him. They said he was glowing, George, glowing because he had had so much time and intimacy with God, and he could feel the prayers of so many around the world. So please keep praying for Pastor Saeed Abedini.
Exactly. Terrific interview. This week, the UN called for a political transition in Syria and condemned the Assad regime for its use of heavy weapons in populated areas. The UN backed an Arab-backed resolution calling for change in the leadership. 107 nations supported the resolution, which is not legally binding, by the way. More than 70,000 people have died in Syria's two-year civil war, and hundreds of thousands of refugees have fled to neighboring countries like Turkey, Jordan, Lebanon, and Iraq. Christians in those countries are reaching out to help those refugees. Recently, I spoke with Jack Shiflett of the Association of Baptists for World Evangelism about those activities. Jack Shiflett is with the Association of Baptists for World Evangelism. He's recently returned from the Middle East, where he saw firsthand the work of local churches helping Syrian refugees. He joins us now via Skype. Can you describe the living conditions of these refugees and tell us what their needs are?
The living conditions are terrible. You're talking about one quarter of the population of Assyria, they're estimating, is outside of their own borders. And then within the country, they're talking about 5.5 million displaced people. So their lives, their homes are destroyed. They're in terrible conditions. They have need of everything. Some have been on long journeys. A mother with six or seven children would actually hike for miles and miles to cross the border to find refugee space or some hope, at least to get away from the violence.
There are Christian humanitarian groups and relief workers on hand. Tell us about their work and the impact that they're having.
Give you an idea of what we're running into. 80,000 people have been killed in the last 2 years. So that's the size of the city of Youngstown, Ohio. That would mean every man, woman, and child in that town killed and traumatized and fleeing out there somewhere. So that's what we're finding. The local churches, maybe a local church of 50 to 70 people, will be caring for 700. And they don't ask any questions about their religious faith or their ethnic backgrounds. And this is something that is absolutely astounding for the region.
And in ordinary circumstances, these people might be considered as enemies, yet they're reaching out to help. Why?
Absolutely. They would be the enemies. Most Christian minorities live in fear and anger. That would be the way they look at it because their countries have been destroyed. They're a minority. They have all of that pressure, lack of rights. But we've seen God work in the life of the church, so they take the spirit of Christ and they see, like the Good Samaritan, just a fellow human being suffering, and they've reached out to them. And they do it in the name of Christ. And it's interesting that sometimes when they're ministering to these people, they will say, "You know, we're not Christians, right?" Because they have no category for this kind of love. And Christians pause and they say, let us explain to you who this God is who cares for you. And they are absolutely amazed. They pray with him. And they said, God cares about us. He's not a God who is distant, but cares about our lives. So they're coming to the services. They're listening week after week to the good news as a result of this work.
And Wendy, you were there, you reported on the Christian activities of Syrian refugees. By the way, you can go and view those stories, not just from Wendy, but Gary, as well as Chris Mitchell. Those stories can be seen on our website. Just go to cbnnews.com. We'll be back right after this.
From CBN.
Broken Eardrum is playing at the Civic tonight.
And you'll just have to miss it.
This is so incredibly unfair.
A special story of love and sacrifice.
Joy, Mom comes up with something.
Christopher Quantum, you and I are going to discuss your attitude right this minute.
Superbook.
No.
Join the Superbook DVD Club and get Superbook's newest episode, He Is Risen. Plus, two copies to share with others. All for your gift of $25.
They have arrested Jesus, the Messiah. Do you not know that I have the power to crucify you?
No! Please! You can't!
They've taken him to Golgotha. We must hurry.
Mary is about to lose her son. The worst thing any mother could face. I am not leaving her.
Superbook. It's an amazing way to build a strong spiritual foundation in the children you love.
Mary, who are you looking for?
I've seen him! He is alive!
Superbook. He is risen. Available now.
It's a question each one of us must face. It's the most important decision you'll ever make. Where will you spend eternity?
In Gordon Robertson's newest DVD, Life Beyond the Grave, Part 2, you'll meet real people who have died and experienced heaven or hell. See their personal eyewitness accounts of what happens when we die.
There's more love than you can imagine.
I was comforted. I had a peace and joy I've never had.
In Life Beyond the Grave, Part 2, you'll discover a powerful tool to share the gospel with those you love, what the Bible says about eternal life, and how you can know for certain that heaven is your destiny.
I was absolutely overwhelmed by this sensation of being home.
You can have the assurance that when you die and are absent from your body, you'll be present with Jesus for all eternity.
And welcome back to the show. In 2008, the Rumaiki family fled Germany for the United States because they wanted freedom to homeschool their children. In Germany, parents who homeschool are hounded, persecuted, fined, and sometimes jailed. Now, the family has been told they cannot stay in America. Dale Hood has that story.
The appeals court upheld the Obama administration's refusal of asylum to the Romaika family. The Romaikas fled Germany in 2008 facing criminal prosecution for homeschooling. They live in Tennessee. In 2010, they were granted political asylum by an immigration judge. But that decision was overturned by the Board of Immigration Appeals last year. And Tuesday, the three-judge panel of the Sixth Circuit issued a unanimous decision against the family. Uwe and Hannelore Romaika began homeschooling in Germany because they didn't want their children exposed to things like witchcraft and graphic sex education that are taught in German schools.
Also, there were stories where they were encouraged to ask the devil for help instead of God, and actually the devil would help.
We found out what is in the textbooks. It's exactly the opposite from what the Bible tells us and teaches us, and we wanted to protect them.
While the appeals court acknowledged that the U.S. Constitution recognizes the rights of parents to homeschool, it refused to grant that what German homeschoolers face amounts to persecution deserving of asylum. Michael Ferris of the Homeschool Legal Defense Association, which represented the Romaikas, said, "We believe the Sixth Circuit is wrong and we will appeal their decision." The Romaikas told CBN News they're disappointed, but said God is in control. They know what they face in Germany if they're deported.
First, they would fine us with increasingly high fines, and they would threaten us to take away custody. There might be jail time too. But the main threat, I think, is the aspect of custody, because then, of course, the children are taken away from you completely, and I mean, that's what no family wants, right?
Dale Hurd, CBN News.
Thanks, Dale. In Philadelphia, a jury convicted abortionist Kermit Gosnell of murder for killing babies born alive in his clinic. He's been sentenced to 3 life terms in prison, but some say, more importantly, his case may change the national debate over abortion in America. Our John Jessup has been covering the trial.
Throughout the 8-week trial, late-term abortion doctor Kermit Gosnell and his attorney maintained his innocence. But immediately after learning his fate,
Dr. Gosnell, your reaction to the murder.
He had nothing to say. In the end, jurors found the evidence to convict Gosnell on multiple counts of first-degree murder for killing 3 newborn infants after they'd been born alive. He was also guilty of involuntary manslaughter in the death of a 41-year-old immigrant who died from a drug overdose during a botched abortion. It took jurors, none of whom identified as pro-life, 10 days to convict Gosnell on those charges and more than 200 other counts violating Pennsylvania's abortion laws.
I respect what juries do. I don't always agree, but I respect everything that they did, and they should be commended for their efforts.
Gosnell operated this clinic in West Philadelphia for 30 years before it was ultimately brought down for illegally prescribing painkillers. But what investigators found was far worse. They described his clinic as a house of horrors, with blood-stained walls, unsterilized medical equipment, and fetal remains stored in the employee refrigerator.
It is clear that this person was not following the rules, and we have a role in society of making sure that those people who don't follow the law pay the consequences of not following the law.
It is a case that's left a dark stain on Philadelphia, one some hope to remove.
This year alone, just in these last 4 months, we've saved 10 babies. The most recent was just a week ago.
Elaine Russo runs the Hope Pregnancy Center, not far from where Gosnell practiced. It's on track to save more lives than it did last year, 27. The center is the brainchild of Pastor Herb Lusk, who ministers in the heart of the inner city.
1 out of every 2 pregnancies in the African-American community right now are aborted. 1 out of every 2.
Lusk says he decided to start the center after he noticed women in the church who, in his words, were pregnant one Sunday and no longer pregnant the next.
I kept seeing them, what is going on? And realized that with all the abortion mills in our neighborhood, that many of them were using abortion almost as birth control. At that point, I knew that I had to do something, and just talking about it was not going to be enough.
Even now, with the clinic closed and Dr. Gosnell convicted, many in the pro-life movement say the fight is far from over. They worry there may be many other clinics that may be operating under the radar, just like Kermit Gosnell's clinic did. John Jessup, CBN News, Philadelphia.
Up next, Understanding Islam and Its Followers, the new DVD series that's helping Christians introduce Muslims to Jesus Christ.
CBNNews.com. News you want, when you want, 24/7. Stay current with up-to-the-minute stories.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News, New York.
I don't have to wait for my news anymore.
CBNNews.com, at your fingertips all day long.
I only watch the stories I want to see.
I find the story, I click on it, and boom, I'm there.
Embassy in Washington, Eric Stackelbeck, CBN News.
The source for your news, CBNNews.com.
Hi, this is Pat Robertson. This is an important time in the history of America. It's an important time in the history of CBN. And what you do is so very important now. But we've got to get the gospel out here in America. We've got to help the poor and the needy. Feed those who are hungry, clothe those who are naked, bring medical attention to those who are suffering, and more than anything, bring hope to those who are without hope throughout the world. So your 700 Club membership makes a huge difference. And I ask you to go to your phone and call. If you haven't already called in, we appreciate what you've done so much. So don't slack. We don't want our hands to be empty. We want to say, Lord, here are those who have come to you because of my labors. Telephones are available, toll-free line, and we just thank God for each one of you. So don't hesitate to call and do it now.
It was the most angelic, the most
peaceful, safe, loving place.
I wasn't afraid.
There was not a feeling of time.
I was comforted. I had a peace and joy I've never had.
I was absolutely overwhelmed by this sensation of being home.
You just can't even imagine.
Here's a big question. How should Christians respond to Islamic terrorism? Terror attacks can cause some people to fear their Muslim neighbors. Well, a new DVD series is instructing Christians about Islam and how to share their faith without fear. It's all being done with the help of former Muslims. Gary Lane shows us more.
Most Muslim immigrants come to North America for educational and economic opportunities. Others come to escape oppression. On a rare occasion, some, like the Tsarnaev brothers, harm the nation that has welcomed them. Wajdi Iskander is a former Muslim from Sudan.
Suddenly, when they come here, they change. They change to be fanatic.
Government can only do so much to protect us from Islamic fanaticism. So how should we respond beyond praying for our nation? A new Christian DVD teaching series called Truth Unlocked provides spiritual and educational responses.
I think it's going to help our nations, our countries, to be well-equipped to deal with terrorism and to also deal with the people here that we need to take care of, the Muslim people that God brought here for us to give them the gospel right here.
The Truth Unlocked DVD series provides an understanding of Islamic religious beliefs. Tim Clemens is co-producer of Truth Unlocked.
This came about with just our kids interacting with other Muslim kids within their school. And I felt very ill-equipped and ignorant towards another culture that had moved in.
El Hayat Woman's talk show host Amani Mostafa appears on the Truth Unlocked DVD. She is a former Muslim who says Westerners should understand Islamic culture before establishing a relationship with a Muslim.
A man and his wife are welcoming a couple into their home, and the man of the house would extend the hand to shake the hand of the wife. Instantly, she's offended because she's veiled and she's not supposed to be shaking a man's hand. Right there, he broke, a rule. So it takes a while for us to correct these things.
Terror attacks like the Boston Marathon bombing may cause people to shy away from pursuing a relationship with Muslims. Mostafa says Christians shouldn't fear sharing their faith because Muslims hunger for closeness to God.
When a Christian person come and present to me the God that he loves and worships and live with, that is an eye-opener and a heart-opener to many of us. And we see today that when Muslims are offered the freedom to choose Christ, they do, by the millions.
And Christians don't have to read the Quran before witnessing to Muslims.
I think it's a lot more important for them to understand what the gospel say, how to relate the gospel to them, to the Muslims.
Mostafa says Christians should tell the truth.
Ask him about what is that God, who is that God you're worshiping, and tell them the truth. We don't worship the same God, and let me tell you why.
A follow-up DVD called Far From Home, A Different West will be available in the near future.
The big difference is one is designed for Joe Average in the North American pew. The other is designed specifically to give to a Muslim. It is going to be a tool that can be used to reach Muslims around the globe.
Most evangelism tools are created and presented by Western Christians. This one is done by former Muslims who now follow Jesus.
The Christian, they explain it in a Christian mindset, but now you have kind of a convert, a believer in Christ from the same background who understand exactly what they're going through because we went through it.
One that addresses Muslim misconceptions and questions about Christianity.
Well, as a Muslim, I always wondered, how could God stoop down and come as a man to earth?
Mm-hmm. I think the question is, why would God want to do that? Yeah. The problem was resolved when I knew that God is not stooping down to the level of man. Mm-hmm. God loves man.
Exactly. It's my neighbor, my coworker, it's my child's schoolmate. They're individuals who need Christ as much as anybody else, as much as I needed Christ.
A revelation replacing acts like this with more of this. Gary Lane, CBN News.
Okay, we'll be back right after this. We've got some special news. We'll take a break. Back right after this.
Come on. Give me that. Bye. Sure, life is busy, but I found a way to make a huge difference in people's lives. I guess you could say I'm changing the world right here from home. I bring medical supplies and doctors to people in need and dig wells so that villagers can have clean and safe water to drink. I make it possible to preach the gospel in over 100 countries, including right here in America. And when disaster strikes, I'm there, providing food, thank you, and emergency supplies to give people hope again. Every day, CBN and I are making the world a better place. Here you go. My life is hectic, so I join CBN through Pledge Express. My bank does all the work, and I know that my gift is being used where it's needed most. So become a CBN partner and join Pledge Express, because you can do a world of good right from where you are. Hi, good morning. Are you ready to get started?
What if you knew heaven is real because you'd seen it?
Everything's alive, nothing's dead.
Because you'd been there.
There's more love than you can imagine.
How would it change the way you live your life?
He was so eager. We gotta get people saved. We gotta let people know about Jesus.
Get the real story from people who've experienced life beyond the grave.
I was hungry and you gave me something to eat.
I was thirsty and you gave me something to drink.
I was a stranger and you invited me in.
I needed clothes and you clothed me.
I was sick and you looked after me.
I was in prison and you came to visit me.
Your giving makes it all possible. Call and join the 700 Club today.
Well, folks, there's a man who works behind the scenes, has been doing this for the last 10 years. His name is Steve Little. He's the producer of Christian World News. He's been here 10 years. We'd like to honor him. Take a look at this video.
Shh. He's right over there. Hey, Steve.
You're one of the kindest and smartest people I've ever known.
I'm honored to be working with you.
Congratulations on 10 years at CBN.
Here's to 10 more.
I am so happy to work with Steve.
You have a heart for telling good stories, stories about what God is doing around the world.
God bless you, and hope you have another great 10 years.
And we have Steve Little on set today. Yes. Thank you so much for all you do for us. We love you, and we so appreciate it for what you guys do every week. You're just awesome. Thank you so much for making the name of Jesus Christ famous around the world each week. Guess what? You get a chance to say goodbye.
You get to say it.
Read the script. Quickly.
Thanks for joining us this week. Until next week, goodbye, and God bless you.
God bless you. Yes.